Number 11 is Camilo Contar Reyes. Number 13 is Jorge Gomez. So we just continue because the.
No, just keep on saying
that. Okay, 17 is Jeff. Number 15 is Carlos Santiveri. Number 27 is Jorge Gomez. Number 21 is Maggi Rovira. Number 23, Daniel Garcia. Number 24, Victor Gonzalez. Number 69, Juan Hernandez. Number 81, Alexis Bustamante.
Okay, so Viana got the ball first. Now we started the game 30 seconds ago. Then ball got recovered by Barcelona. They were a bit at the Viana basket and counter-attacked by the Viennese. Now we are at the Barcelona basket. It seems to be quite an equal game right now. Let's see how it keeps on going. Barcelona has the ball,
passing down, achieving to get to the Viana basket, trying to play out the corner, setting up their attack, passing to number 69.
We have the first player exchanges here on the Viana side.
So Barcelona is trying to play the ball around the basket to get their chance to get into the defense of Viana. So now we have a referee call, and it's a free throw.
Grabbing the head. It's a free throw for Viana. So I have a question for Colombo. Which team do I cheer? None of them. I don't like playing against either of them. I would say maybe a bit more Viana, because I know them better, but I'm not for any of those teams.
For the best team to win, no. And we're in a scrum at the bottom of the pool in the middle. Viana got hold of the ball, trying to pass through. Barcelona is setting up their defense. They could manage to steal the ball, trying to get past the middle line. And we're in the ball position of white, which is Barcelona, reaching the Viana basket, trying to play again around, trying to find some space in the defense to attack properly. And that's, oh, there was one Barcelona person struggled up in the referee cable, but now we have a free throw for Barcelona against Viana, playing outside the playing area. We see the Viana defense quite set up, and now we have Carlos Santiveri with the ball, passing to, that is an ad proper chance. Number 9, Camilo Gaetan, had the first real chance to score, passing to Chef at the bottom of the closed side, and they're still in ball possession. Viana is also doing a great job defending the basket and not letting Barcelona reach.
Yes, but still, Barcelona is dominating so far.
Yes.
Most of the game so far has been around the Viana basket.
Yeah.
And now they're trying to get out. Okay, ball goes through the surface.
Number one, Albert, is trying to catch off the ball, slowing down the counterattack.
Missing a bit of passing positions here on the Viana side of Janowe. He's now waiting down, was not seen. The pass was back actually by Barcelona, quite to the goalie from 3 meters out.
Yes.
This is a very interesting move actually.
Mm-hmm. Now they're fighting again for the ball in the middle of the pool. Barcelona managed to break free, reaching the Viana basket, playing out the corner. Playing around the basket as well. Daniel, number 23, is trying to get past the defense. Okay, ooh, that was still in more possession of Barcelona.
Viana has a very consistent defense.
Yes,
have very good defensive forechecking is very present in here, and so the Barcelona players cannot really get to the basket. They cannot get to the defenders, which is always when it gets dangerous.
Yes.
Once, even if the defenders are...
Oh, they lost the ball. There was a call attacking the head. Free throw for Viana.
Let's see how it evolves.
a quite interesting match so far. I think both teams, like, we have 5 minutes played and 5 minutes left of the first half, and we see here two, let's say, equal teams trying to win.
Yes.
And overall, we have played, or we have seen them play more over the Vienna basket. Barcelona managed really to set up the defense and breaking back again at the Vienna basket when they're playing right now at the Barcelona basket.
So was
after
a
free throw,
was I think Jan Kielemann passing the ball to the front, back down.
That's an attack, but there are like 2, 3, 4 players down from Barcelona. So we have quite still at the now the goalie. Oh, that was grabbing the hat. That was pulling back one of the Barcelona players at the hat. And let's see what the referee calls. What? What's? Oh, it's a free throw for Barcelona. So they start in the corner, Chef in ball possession, trying to swim around the defense. Here comes Quantis, trying to play around the basket.
It's interesting that Barcelona is dominating the game so much, actually.
I would have expected
to be a bit more equal, actually,
yes.
The game.
So now we have another attack on the basket. Now by Alexis, number 81 from Barcelona. Struggling here. You see Vienna fighting really hard because they also want to win this. And now we have a struggle at the surface, but still Barcelona in ball possession. Trying to break.
It's two very hot-blooded teams, so it will get more and more heated, this game. Let's see how it evolves. So free throw against Vienna, again, signaled, I think it's Birgit Lütke underwater. I'm not sure.
It looks like her, yes.
Yes, so we have Hamel on the surface, Birgit Lütke
again,
and Manuel Tito de Moraes as referees underwater.
Nice.
Free throw for Vienna, holding with a ball.
So we have 2 minutes left in the first half.
Markus Wimmer here with the ball, I think.
In the middle of the field. Vienna is trying to get past the Barcelona players, who are trying to get possession of the ball again. There was a struggle and another referee call from upstairs.
For
there's
Vienna.
Like again for Vienna, free throw.
Thomas Denk here, who got the ball,
yes.
Underwater.
They pass
over Wisna, has the ball.
Now they manage to get a little bit closer to the Barcelona basket, trying to attack, but there are 3 people down, and the defense is struggling.
Ooh, Wisna.
Who's?
No, Wisna.
Oh, there, I got hit. A hold of the ball, still in the scrum at the surface right now. Still at the Barcelona side. There was now, I think, ball possession is Vienna. Yes, the ball dropped and there was 2 players fighting for it, so we can't, right, there's the ball. Barcelona is in ball possession again.
So the ball fell, was intercepted by Vienna, or was it the pass? We don't know who had it on the surface. Santa Vienna players are more in the half for Barcelona. Not as present as they could be, but now we have three players, and it's half time. So let's see how the second half time evolves. Actually,
it's a really intense, interesting game.
A lot of fouls. Yeah, a lot of free throws.
Yes.
And both teams.
Hello.
Hi. Good morning. Let's see how it goes, because I know that they can get both teams a bit aggressive, and none of them is happy now with how it's going, I guess, 0-0, and they want the win. So let's see.
It was in their group,
so they have in their group Malch. They both lost against Malch yesterday, and so they're fighting for the second spot in the group.
So there we see the Barcelona girls supporting the guys that play later. And right now we have a change of sides. So far we have had an intense first half of the game. I think they'll do some switches. Barcelona had brought enough players to make changes.
In Vienna too, we saw before some players with towel on the head, so I guess we'll have a couple switches as well. Or maybe they'll decide not to switch, because sometimes you start with the strongest players, and if you see that you're still going 0-0, maybe you're like, okay, we don't switch to a bit newer or less experienced players, so we are sure to keep on giving our best effort. Yes, Camilo saying hi to the camera. Okay,
so should I do a quick move? Resume of the game in Spanish. So para todos que están escuchando y no nos entienden en inglés, tenemos un partido muy justo de dos equipos que tienen en su grupo Malch, que es un equipo alemán super fuerte, y ahora está jugando Viena contra Barcelona, y todos manejaron el balón super bien, nadie logró sacar un gol. Entonces es 0-0, de los equipos están jugando super fuertes, con mucho fuego, porque quieren ganarlo. Y si vamos a ver qué pasa en este segundo tiempo, que van a pasar en 30 segundos, y aquí vemos el equipo de Barcelona con los chicos con las chicas apoyándoles.
Sí. A ver, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo dice la gente ahora en el chat, en el live stream? La gente se nota un poco que Viena está un poco más cansado, son jugadores un poco más mayores, también tienen jugadores más nuevos, más inexperimentados. A ver cómo sigue ahora se desarrolla el juego el segundo tiempo, que va a ser muy calentado. Hay un montón de fouls, y a ver cómo sigue.
Ok, we're back in the second time. Vienna got hold of the ball, struggling there still in the middle against Barcelona, who's in ball possession. You can't right now. There's one Barcelona playing, holding on to the ball really tight. They're in a tough scrum going to the surface. There the ball drops, but that's a referee call from the open side referee, I guess. So and that's a free throw for
Barcelona, I guess. I don't know.
I couldn't see
what
it
was
quite
called.
Clear.
I guess it was holding
without the ball. So Barcelona is trying strong there, passing back, trying to get to the corner. They managed to get to the corner of the Vienna basket, trying to attack. There we have Carlos Santivari, number 15. But they're still in ball possession on the closed side of the Vienna basket. Really smoothly playing the ball around the basket, but Vienna is defending really good, so Barcelona couldn't get close to the basket.
They're not letting any holes in their defense,
yes.
And have always goalie, defender, and a forechecker in between.
Yes.
The defensive
right
block
four,
and
five
the ball
down there.
Yes. So they're good at overlapping underwater. They have enough players. They can switch, and they're experienced players as well.
Yes.
Now, but Barcelona is moving, is swimming around the basket, but it's Colombian style, right? Swimming around the basket, moving the ball,
tiring them down,
and trying to confuse the defense as well. but not fast enough to actually confuse them.
Yes.
You have someone in position on the open side of the basket as well.
Here's coming number one, Albert, trying to tackle him from behind Jorge Gomez. He's always missing one player. We saw this kind of game yesterday as well, and there's always missing one player there to set up the attack, playing around the basket a little bit faster to get in there when there's
there. It's like Barcelona is resting a bit in attack. They're moving the ball, but they're missing a third person to be there and actually be able to attack, I think.
So right now we are back at the Barcelona basket. Viena managed to break through.
Yes, and...
and now they're struggling with Leo, number 7 from Barcelona. Now Viena setting up their attack. And
We're missing some Viena players here. I think that's Peter Marmitrick here coming down to the
that's close
basket against.
Somebody broke through. I think it's Camilo Gaetan who broke through, but he passes to Chef, but they're now they're coming in. There's Leo coming in the Barcelona players.
It was a very fast counter-attack, but Viena managed to have a goalie position as well. The defender got there also just when he left.
Another graphic call. It's a free throw for Barcelona,
grabbing onto the head.
They really want to win this. Our timeout.
One of the teams asked for a timeout.
We cannot see which team so far, and the time isn't running yet. So
Barcelona. That's a timeout for Barcelona. Yeah, so both teams really want to win, and there's what, 5 minutes left on this halftime?
Yes,
a bit less.
I think so.
5:50.
So it's a really hot game.
Yes, and as we were saying before, now for the first time in the group phase, there is no equal games, there is no draws, so if the game ends in a draw, there will be a penalty shootout.
Yes. It will be interesting how the penalty shoot, if we go to penalty shooters, how it will go.
Yes, because I know that the Viena team is quite good at penalty shootouts. They have big, the goalkeepers are big, they're experienced, they're heavy, fast players.
And then we have on the Barcelona side some players who are really fast, so maybe that's...
And it's interesting because when they go to the surface, for instance, Viena is stronger at grabbing the ball, holding onto the ball, and Barcelona's a bit more fast and moving around.
So now we're executing a free throw from Barcelona, and there are three players down there trying to get to the Viena basket, managing quite good. They're still in ball possession. Now at the close side, so we can't see so much. Now they're trying to get in. There's, whoa, that was close. Did you saw that? He passed from the open side to the close side, and now there's no goalie, but a scrum right over the basket. Number 7, Leo, is holding on there.
The Viena players are physically they're strong.
Yeah.
So the Barcelona cannot, they don't really dare to go, to attack actually, to get into... really close to the basket.
And now they're trying to swim in, and there was somebody holding a player, so he couldn't swim quite near where he wanted to. But I think right now they're attacking a little bit more. You see number 7, he's training a lot outside the pool as well, but he's not the tallest player, but he has some mass built up. And now Camilo is attacking, one against them, but there are two Viena players coming fastly in, and they were missing some Barcelona players. Now number 17 is trying to block at the Viena basket, but the ball is too far away and he has to breathe. Now there are two Barcelona players against three Viena players, that's what we saw. They're missing one person down there, or they're positioning themselves too far away around the basket. So Vienna is always playing with two players, four players.
You always have a forechecker in between the different Barcelona players, the one waiting at the basket and the one with the ball 3 meters away. And Barcelona got the ball again. It's like Vienna seems to be waiting for Barcelona to do a mistake. Both teams are actually waiting for the other to leave out.
And now I like this was close. That's Chef trying to attack, but there is the defenders who move right into it. And then the
you see how the Vienna goalie and defender went down casually, got there on time. You see they're looking comfortable in their defense. Like this is Viennese attitude. We're here. We know we're good. We should win. You're not better than us. That's how it feels with the way they're defending. Oh, and now we have a close try by Schneiderbauer over the goalie.
And the Barcelona basket will be right now. Barcelona is in ball possession, but that's close, but they're... Like, that's really interesting. So when Vienna is attacking the Barcelona basket, they all also don't like any defense players. They're always there, two, three players, and now they break through. But when they're attacking, right now...
They're attacking. They're going to the goalie.
Yeah.
Barcelona doesn't really do. They wait way longer. They don't take as many chances and as many risks.
And in defending, Barcelona is also really present. But when they attack, they're always missing somebody. So they should be more confident in also building up their attacks quite strong in waves, really fast. So now, 2.5 minutes left in this game. It's quite... intense, it's still 0-0. In blue team we have Vienna and in white we have Barcelona. We saw a lot of playing around the Vienna basket with some hold-ups at the Barcelona basket.
Now the ball fell on the ground, could have been an opportunity for the Viennese defender to actually turn around and get it. It was a bit risky, but Chef
lost the ball to one of the Vienna players, the opposite team from Barcelona, and now they managed to get it again and playing from the open side, but there's one Barcelona player which you can't see, but we guess he's there. And then on the other side we have another one, but do you see the ball? Ah, there it is. One of the Barcelona players has it now trying there, but...
And Vienna is always there in defense. It's impressive. They've been defending 60% of the game, I think, they were in defense.
And now one of the forwards has interfered and has the ball.
Passing to Schneiderbauer, got the ball, trying to swim out his by himself though.
Yeah,
passing through the ground, a rebound pass.
Ooh. So, defending Barcelona, and there are four people down there again trying to get hold of the ball, but Vienna is establishing an attack. There's one person who stole the defender's position, but now he has got up.
Schneiderbauer has the ball again, waiting around Barcelona basket. That's the problem now. The Viennese players are world defender all the time. They need to recollect, get a bit of air to be able to attack.
Yes.
But,
now we're just on the open side of the Barcelona, there's always one Viennese player there, like heads up, but Camilo Gaetan got the ball, tries to break free of the defender. They're 3-4 play. Now he got Barcelona is in ball position again, passing right into the hands of the field. Attacking again, but there's forward. Another wave of defenders coming in, trying to get hold of the ball. It's
10 seconds left. So if no one scores, if Vienna doesn't score, now it will be
penalty
shootouts.
And then just trying to hold on, and that's it. So we're going to a penalty shootout. Really
interesting. I think it's the first game that has two. There was one game yesterday.
Yeah.
Makos. Women's game, yes, Helvetia Makos, it was 3-3 and they had Helvetia from Switzerland won against the Connecticut Makos 4-3 with penalty shootout, and now a first men's game that ends 0-0 actually and has to go through shootout.
And it's really equal games, so we saw Vienna defending a lot.
Actually, Colombo asked before who I'm for, actually I think I'm a bit more for Vienna, to be honest, but you're for Barcelona, so that's okay.
So we have two sides here. So it will be interesting how they manage to do this. So I saw in Barcelona, I was training with them 2 weeks ago, and they're trying practice the penalties. Let's see how it goes against Vienna. So it's really exciting to see them.
Sí, y para los que no nos entienden en inglés, el partido acabó 0-0. Esta vez por la primera vez no se puede acabar un partido con empate, así que vamos directamente a penaltis. Es el primer partido masculino que sí. Tiene que acabar en penaltis, el primer que empate 0-0. Fue un juego muy intenso, bastantes fouls cometidos.
Sí.
En el primer medio tiempo, el segundo ya fue mejor, un poco más fair play. Sí. Pero sí. Let's see who is attacking here for Vienna. I think it's Thomas Denk. Looks like Thomas Denk.
And we have Alejo, number 5, trying to get hold of the ball, defending. It's quite a good.
What's holding onto the head? And goal. Goal for Vienna.
But this. No, that's. I think it doesn't count. It doesn't. I think it doesn't count.
Oh, that's goal. It does.
Yeah, the foul was committed by the.
Yes. Because the foul, if it was a foul, it was committed by the goalkeeper who was holding onto the head of the attacker, but then he scored, so.
So
next
this was to go.
Is it Lorena, do you know if it is 1-1, each team scores one? Okay. So if one team is one at a time, yes.
Let's see who will attack for Barcelona.
I guess it's Matthias Neunteufel defending, I guess.
Okay, so if Camilo Gaetan attacking from the top, getting under the goalie, doing the Möller, the bottle opener. Yeah, and that's oh, did you see that? Oh my gosh.
Next to the basket, and
he was so sure that it was in, and Vienna got hold of the ball.
Vienna wins the game.
It was
I'm a bit
so
happy.
Close.
Honestly, yeah. So, and Lorena just said it here behind in the booth. If a team wins a game, normally during the game time, it's three points for the team, and if they win with penalty shootouts, it is they get 2 points.
Okay.
But now Barcelona has lost both the games. Vienna has lost one,
yes.
1-1. So for their group, we have Malch first, Vienna second, and Barcelona third, as they were actually placed as the placed in the group.
So for the ones who don't play rugby and have seen the penalty, the ball has to enter fully into the basket, and we saw the Barcelona playing being really sure of it getting in there, but it dropped out, it wasn't fully in, and the Vienna player could manage to get possession of the ball and bring it up to the surface, so he defended it. Quite well, or used the second chance there was.
So. Okay, and last game now for the men's group phase. We have in blue the Unidive Gulls from Brisbane in Australia against the Boston Narwhals from the USA. So the it's Group A, the last game for Group A. They both lost yesterday against Orcas. So Gulls lost 11-0 and Boston lost 15-0 against Orcas. It's two teams that are with an average experience level, and it will be interesting. They have some fast players, both yesterday had some surprises, they got some goals scored on empty baskets. So let's see how it will go today. So I have Beate joining me now, replacing Annika. Good morning, Beate.
Yeah, good morning, everyone.
So
good morning to your fans. So we have 87 people watching us now. I think those fans can watch us.
But Western guys need to get up in the middle of the night to watch the game. I think they all should be
number 7.
Do we have some Western in the chat?
Yes, I think those fans can watch us like 8 p.m.
Right.
there, so that should be okay for them. Do you want to read the list for Boston?
Yeah, sure. So Boston is
Number 2 is Thomas. Number 5 is Joshua. Number 6 is Timmy. Number 8 is Sid. Number 10, Tommy. And number 11 is Katie. Great. The lady in the team. I think she makes a difference. And number 12 is Jay. Number 15, Christian. Number 17, Joseph. Number 19, Matteo. Number 31 is Mike. 66, Jan. 99 is John. So we do have four quite good defenders.
Okay,
and for Jan, John, and Katie, I think they will be great.
And for the goals, we have number 1, Federico Corrales, 3, Hannah Barringer, 7, Ricardo Riarte, 8, Jake Williams, 10, David Torres, 11, Daniel Lopez, 14, Nicolas Ley, 17, Jared Carney, 18, Victor Gavillon, 19, Rob Patterson, 20, Luke Jacobides, 24, Lopez Nuñez, Louis, who's the vice captain, 40, John Phillips, 44, Johnny Wilson, the lady in the team, who's also the captain, and 88, Benjamin Wang. So let's see how this game goes. It will be interesting.